I wanted you to quickly tell me, you saw Regis when you were a maitre d' or a host at a restaurant? Yeah, and he came over to you. Could you just tell us that story really quick?
Yeah, it was the coolest, craziest thing. And, you know, it happened so long ago, like 10 years ago or something like that. But when he had passed, it was so sad for me because I got to experience the Reg in a very weird way, that there were no cameras. He didn't know anybody I knew. There was no way to, there was nothing in it for him to be nice and kind to a boy who was handing out menus at a time when I was in LA and I knew nobody. And I couldn't catch an audition to save my life. Nothing was happening. Nothing was happening, and nothing happened for a very long time after that. But he had come into this restaurant that I had worked at, and I like freaked out. And, you know, me being very subtle, I was like, pull it together, Hoffman, pull it together, you know, like just get it together and play it cool. And I did no such thing. And it was the tiniest restaurant. And, you know, I had 30 seconds to walk him to his table. And I walked so slow, Tori. I think it took me like 20 minutes to get to the table. He must have been like, oh, he got hit by a car. Like, why
poor
is
guy.
And I got to tell him in 30 seconds, you know, that like I grew up watching him with my grandma. My grandma would put on, you know, Regis and Kathy Lee, and I would watch him, and I wanted to be a TV host, and I moved out to LA to be a TV host, and just meeting him is like the coolest thing ever. And, you know, I just, you know, gave him the gush, much more eloquent now than what was happening in real life, trust me. And he sat down, he ordered his lunch. And 10 minutes later, and I had went back to the host stand, and I lost maybe 40 pounds in sweat.
For sure.
I
was like, oh, just boring. So
just dripping, drenched, as if I was in a water balloon fight. And he came up to me. He sat down. He ordered his meal. 10 minutes later, he came up to the host stand with nobody around, nothing, whatever. And he said, so you want to be in TV? And he said, what are you doing to get there? You know, how is everything going for you? And I could tear up even thinking about it, because a titan like that, talking to someone who wanted to just be in the biz so bad and had no tools on how to do that, and for him to give of his time in a, you know, in a generous way, was just the coolest thing. And when he had passed, I just was like, oh my God, that's so sad. And then I remembered what he had done. And you know, when you're in that, the position that I was in at that time, something like that, a gesture like that, it's not like, oh, cool day. That, you take that with you for a month, 6 months, a year. And you're like, well, Regis, give me the oomph, you know? And it's just, it just keeps you on that that hot tin roof a little longer. And he did that for me. And he was just, it was the nicest. And you could tell he was as nice as everybody said. Because I always say, if you were nice to the guy handing out menus, you are it, you know?
You are it. That's so true.
It. So he was so kind, and his aura is everything I would hope I could touch within a glimmer of his orbit.